इन्वर्टर इज द सिंपल लॉजिक गेट इन एनी लॉजिक फैमिली. एट दिस स्टेज वी आर फेमिलियर विद द वर्किंग ऑफ डिप्लेशन लोड एन मॉस इन्वर्टर एंड सी मॉस इन्वर्टर. इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन आई एम गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस बाई सी मॉस इन्वर्टर. सो बिफोर आई स्टार्ट द सर्किट डाइग्राम of various BiCMOS inverter configuration, I would like to tell you that BiCMOS inverter uses CMOS gates at the input stage and the bipolar transistor at the output stage. So we will see four configurations one by one. Okay, so first configuration one. Okay, so here I am going to use two MOS transistor. One is PMOS and another one is NMOS. The gate of NMOS and PMOS transistors are shorted. One of the terminal of NMOS and PMOS transistors are connected to VDD power rail is equal to 5 volt. Okay, the other terminal goes to the base of BJT transistors. Output cap is taken across a capacitor CL. So we have a four transistor, that is T1 PMOS transistor, T2 NMOS transistor, T3 BJT, T4 BJT. Both the BJTs are of NPN type. Now see how exactly it is going to work. We have a two case. Case one, if Vin is equal to 0 and we have a Vout. So case one, Vin is equal to 0. In this case the transistor T1 is on. So when the transistor T1 is on, a base current is going to flow into the transistor T3, which will make the transistor T3 on, and it will charge the output capacitor, that is CL, to logic 1. Now if I want to keep the transistor T3 in active region, VBE of T3 must be 0.7 volt. Okay, it is a minimum voltage required to keep the PN junction in forward bias. Okay, so the V out is going to be equal to VDD minus VBE of transistor T3, that is equal to 5 volt minus 0.7 volt, that is 4.3 volt. So V are not getting the output voltage exactly equal to the power rail, that is VDD, which is at 5 volt. Now, case 2, when V in is equal to logic 1, that is 5 volt. When V in is equal to 5 volt, the transistor T2 is on, and due to this, a base current will flow into the base of transistor T4, and V out is going to be equal to VCE set for transistor T4, that is approximately equal to 0.2 volt. So output signal swings from 4.3 volt to 0.2 volt. Now there are some problems in this circuit. We can see a low resistance path from the VDD to ground, represented by a dotted line, which takes the path VDD, transistor T2, then transistor T4 to ground. The second issue with the circuit: at the beginning we had input 0, so transistor T1 was on. Now if I change my input from logic 0 to logic 1, there are some trapped charge in the base of transistor T3, and we don't have any provision to remove that trapped charge, and this is going to slow down the speed of the logic circuit. Similarly, we don't have a provision to remove the charge of base charge of transistor T4 as well. Another observation: the input stage is made of transistor T1 and T2. They are the MOSFET transistor, and it offers high input impedance, and the output stage is made of transistor T3 and T4, which is BJT transistors, and hence the output stage is having a low output impedance. Now we will see how to improve this, or how to remove the low resistance path from VDD to ground, or sometime it is known as VSS. So let us see the configuration 2. In this case, again, we are going to use 4 transistors, 2 MOSFET, one is PMOS, and another one is NMOS transistors. The gate terminal of both the transistors are shorted. The PMOS source is connected to VDD, and one of the terminal goes to the base of a BJT transistor, which is an NPN transistor. Similarly, the drain of NMOS transistor is connected to the output node, and source of NMOS transistor is connected to the base of another BJT transistor, that is also an NPN transistor. So we have a modified circuit compared to configuration 1. We can see now there is no direct path from VDD to ground. There are 4 transistors. The output, let us assume it is connected to a load capacitor CL, and we have a input Vin. Again, there is two case, there will be a two case for this. So case 1, when Vin is equal to 0. So if Vin is equal to 0, transistor T1 is on. It will lead to a base current to the transistor T3, and transistor T3 is also going to be on, and it is going to charge the output capacitor to the voltage Vout is equal to VDD minus VBE of transistor T3. VDD I have assumed 5 volt. Let us assume that VBE is 0.7 volt. So the output voltage is going to be 4.3 volt. That is logic 1. Now case 2. When Vin is equal to logic 1. When I am changing my input from logic 0 to logic 1, transistor T1 goes off and I don't have any provision to remove the charge trapped at the base of transistor T3. So when our input is logic 1, that is VDD, transistor T2 is on. So there will be, and the voltage stored in the capacitor CL is 4.3 volt. So it will lead to a current into the base of transistor T4. So T4 is also going to be on, and to keep emitter base junction forward bias, we need minimum voltage 0.7 volt. So Vout is going to be equal to 0.7 volt. Again, the problem stated in the earlier circuit, that is there is a stored charge in the base of transistor T3 and T4, and we don't have any provision to remove the trapped charge. So now we will see the third configuration, which is a improved version of the configuration 2. Configuration 3, in this case again we will be using one PMOS transistor, one NMOS transistor along with 2 resistors. The output of PMOS transistor goes to the base of BJT, and we have a parallel resistance between the drain terminal of PMOS transistor and the output node. So we will just redraw it again. We have a BJT transistor and one resistance connected to the output node, and we have a load capacitor CL which is connected to the output node. The source terminal of NMOS goes to another BJT base terminal of BJT, and the emitter of transistor is connected to ground. So we have two resistance, that is R1 and R2, and four transistors, that is T1 a PMOS, T2 an NMOS, T3 and T4 are of NPN type. We have a VDD rail that is equal to 5 volt. Now let us see the working of this configuration 3. Case 1, Vin is equal to 0. So when Vin is equal to 0, the transistor T1 is going to be on and a base current will flow into the base of transistor T3. So transistor T1 is on, transistor T3 is also on, because transistor T2 is off resistance. R1 is not having any use in this circuit for this particular working case, and the output capacitor is going to charge to Vout is equal to VDD minus VBE of T3. It is going to be 5 volt minus 0.7 volt, that is 4.3 volt. Can I say that when my input is 0, the resistance R1 is not having any use? Now, let us assume that if there is some charge available on the base of transistor T4, that will be grounded through the resistance R2. Isn't it? Now, go for case 2, when Vin is logic 1. When I am changing Vin from logic 0 to logic 1, transistor T1 goes off and transistor T2 goes on. Okay, if there is any trapped charge at the base of transistor T3, that will be grounded through the transistor T2 and the resistance R2. Now, when Vin is equal to 1, transistor T2 is on and there is logic 1 stored in capacitor CL. So a current will flow to the base of transistor T4. When this current flows to the base of transistor T4, it will get divided into two parts. One part will go to the base terminal, other part will be grounded through the resistance R2, which is going to make the operation of this circuit slow. but it helps to remove the trapped charge. Okay, so our output is going to be V out is equal to VBE of transistor T4, that is equal to 0.7 volt. Now, the major drawback of this circuit is the precise value of resistance R1 and R2. As you know, when we fabricate a particular resistance, it requires a very large area on the silicon, which leads to decrease in the chip density, and hence it is not preferred to fabricate a resistor inside the BiCMOS logic. So now we are going to remove these two resistors, that is R1 and R2, by a MOS transistor. Now here I want to tell one important thing. We need R1 only if transistor T2 is on. Otherwise, R1 is not required. Okay. So what I am going to do, I am going to replace the R1 with the pull down network. So what is a pull down network of a CMOS stage, that is transistor T2 for the inverter circuit? Okay, so now let us see the configuration 4 and how exactly it works. We require a CMOS inverter at the input stage. This is connected to ground. The output of CMOS inverter goes to the base of a BJT transistor. The collector terminal is connected to VDD. The output terminal is connected to an NMOS transistor, which is a copy of the pull down network of the CMOS stage, and the source terminal of this transistor goes to the base of another BJT transistor, and the emitter of BJT transistor is connected to ground. We require one transistor for resistor R2 in the previous configuration. So that is connected to the base of the BJT transistor as shown in the figure. Okay, so we require this time T1, T2, T3, T4, T5 and T6. Total 6 transistor. Out of 6, 4 are MOSFET and 2 are BJT. So let us see the working of the circuit. Case 1. When V in is equal to 0, If Vin is equal to 0, transistor T1 will be on and transistor T2 and T3 will be in off state. Okay. Now T4 is also in on stage, because if T1 is on, because PMOS transistor passes strong logic 1. So when the T4 is on, whatever the base charge, we have a trapped base charge on the base of transistor T6, it will be grounded through the transistor T4. And because we have a base current at the base of transistor T5, so it will take V out to logic 1, that is equal to VDD minus VBE of T5 is equal to 5 volt minus 0.7 volt, 4.3 volt. So we have a drop of 0.7 volt over here. Now, let us assume that we are changing the input from logic 0 to logic 1, that is case 2, Vin is equal to 1. Transistor T1 goes off and transistor T2 goes on. So whatever the base charge we have at the base of transistor T5, that will be grounded through the transistor T2. So we are able to remove the base charge of transistor T5. Transistor T3 is also on. So it will connect the output node to the base of transistor T6, and hence a base current will flow to the transistor T6, and it will give the V out is equal to 0.7 volt, that is logic 0. Now, in this process, you can see that we have a zero signal at, or logic 0, at the base of transistor T5, which is connected to the base of transistor T4. So it makes the transistor T4 off, and hence there is no current flowing through the transistor T4 to the ground, and hence it is not affecting the speed of the logic circuit. Therefore, we are going to use this particular configuration to implement our BiCMOS logic.